JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's weekly market outlook webinar for the week November the 9th until November the 13th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will describe the most important economic releases and events on the financial agenda for the week ahead. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, this week we have several developments to describe. Over the weekend, Joe Biden won the US elections, so we will discuss how the markets may perform this week in the aftermath of the outcome. We have an RBNZ policy meeting. We don't expect any action, but we will look into the statement for clues and hints with regards to the bank's upcoming plans. We have a new round of Brexit talks, and we also get the US CPIs for October. So let's start with Monday. Let's start with today. Today there are no top tier indicators on the economic agenda. Thus, we believe that market participants will still be digesting the outcome of the US elections. On Saturday, Joe Biden secured 290 electoral votes, officially winning the election race to become the 46th president of the United States. His victory was already largely priced in from last week, with equities around the globe and other risk-linked assets recording gains as investors diverted flows out of the safe havens. As we noted several times last week, a Biden victory is seen as positive for stock indices around the globe, as it is believed that Democrats will adopt a softer stance than Trump in handling the trade relationships of the US with the rest of the world. Indeed, at the time this report was written, Asian indices were a sea of green. Although we said that the Biden presidency may prove negative for stocks in the US due to his pledge to increase corporate taxes and tighten regulation, the fact that Republicans are likely to stay in control of the Senate allowed Wall Street to march higher as well. This will make it hard for Biden to proceed with the aforementioned plans. In the FX world, Biden is seen as negative for the US dollar due to his fiscal agenda being looser than Trump's. Yes, a Republican-controlled Senate may object any suggested package by Biden, but investors continue to sell dollars, perhaps in anticipation that this could pressure the Fed to step up its stimulus efforts at some point in the not-too-distant future. Now, on Tuesday, during the Asian morning, we get China's CPI and PPI for the month of October. The CPI is expected to have slowed to 0.8% year over year from 1.7%, while the PPI rate is forecast to have ticked up to -2% from -2.1%. In the early European morning, the UK employment report for September is due to be released. The unemployment rate is forecast to have risen to 4.8% from 4.5%, while average weekly earnings, including bonuses, are expected to have increased 1% year over year after stagnating in August. The excluding bonuses rate is also anticipated to have risen to 1.5% from 0.8%. That said, according to the KPMG and REC UK report on jobs for September, starting salaries awarded to permanent workers continue to fall solidly, with the rate of decline accelerating slightly since August. Meanwhile, temporary wages fell only modestly. So with that in mind, we would consider the risks surrounding the earnings forecasts as tilted to the downside. From Germany, we have the ZEW survey for November. Both the current conditions and the economic sentiment indices are expected to have declined to minus 65 and 40 from minus 59.5 and 56.1, respectively. At its latest meeting, the ECB noted that in December, the new macroeconomic projections will allow a thorough reassessment of the economic outlook and that the Governing Council will recalibrate its instruments as appropriate. In other words, the ECB is very likely to expand its stimulative efforts in December, and declining ZEW indices will only add to that likelihood. Now, on Wednesday, during the Asian session, the RBNZ decides on monetary policy. When they last met, policymakers of this bank kept their official cash rate and their large-scale asset purchase program unchanged, repeating that further monetary stimulus may be needed in the foreseeable future, including a funding for lending program, a negative official cash rate, and purchases of foreign assets. That said, a few weeks ago, RBNZ Assistant Governor Christian Hogesby said that some economic data have surprised to the upside, reducing the chances for the adoption of negative interest rates by this bank. However, he added that the discussion of negative rates is not a game of bluff, keeping the prospect well on the table. So with that in mind, we don't expect the bank to act at this gathering, but we do expect it to keep the prospect of further easing well on the table. Officials' willingness to take interest rates into the negative territory if needed in the not-too-distant future may hurt somewhat the kiwi, but we expect the currency to stay mostly linked to developments surrounding the broader market sentiment. If the risk on trading due to the outcome of the US election continues, any RBNZ-related slide may stay limited and short-lived. Now, on Thursday, the first estimate of the UK GDP for the third quarter is coming out, and the forecast points to a 15.8% quarter-over-quarter rebound after a minus 19.8% tumble in the second quarter. This will drive the year-over-year rate up to minus 9.4% from minus 21.5%. The nation's industrial and manufacturing production rates for September are also due to be released, and expectations are for both to have improved in year-over-year terms, but to have stayed in the negative territory. In any case, we don't expect this week's data to prove determinant with regards to the pound's forthcoming direction. We stick to our guns that traders of the British currency are likely to keep their gaze locked on developments surrounding the Brexit landscape. Negotiations over a post-Brexit trade accord between the UK and the EU are set to continue this week, with both sides appearing willing to work hard in order to reach common ground. With all that in mind, anything suggesting that the deal could be found in the next few weeks may prove supportive for the British currency, while signs that the differences gap is not narrowing may result in weakness. Later in the day, we have the US CPIs for October. The headline rate is forecast to have ticked down to 1.3% year-over-year from 1.4%, while the core one is anticipated to have held steady at 1.7%. In our view, a downtick in the headline rate is unlikely to increase speculation with regards to additional easing by the Fed in December, especially after Friday's better-than-expected employment data for the month. Therefore, we don't expect the dollar to react much on this release. Rather, we believe that its driver may continue to be the outcome of the US election. Namely, after Biden's victory, the dollar may continue to drift lower. Now, finally, on Friday, Eurozone's second estimate of GDP for the third quarter and the employment change for the same quarter are coming out. The second estimate of GDP is forecast to confirm its preliminary print of 12.7% quarter over quarter, while no forecast is available for the employment change. Later, from the US, we get the PPIs for October and the preliminary University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for November. Both the headline and core PPI rates are expected to have held steady at 0.4% year-over-year and 1.2% year-over-year, respectively, while the University of Michigan Index is forecast to have risen fractionally to 82 from 81.8. So that's it from me. thank you very much for watching and listening. I hope you have a great week, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next Monday. If you are interested in more detailed and frequent analysis, you can find me on our YouTube channel from Tuesday to Friday at around 8:30 a.m. GMT time. So goodbye and have a nice day.
JFT, just fair and direct.